the Stars and the Blues going at it. Inside the season series, Dallas has taken 3 out of 4, 13-7 they outscore them. And you look at the shots per game differential, actually the Blues way outnumbering them. Okay, Panger, you start here. Tell us what we should expect on this one.
This is going to be a heck of a series. I mean, number one, you've got a hometown goaltender coming back, drafted, developed, 4 years in the minors, in Peoria and in St. Louis a little bit, before heading off to Ottawa and then Tampa Bay. He plays well at home. A lot of guys don't do that, but his career against the St. Louis Blues is very impressive. And any time you're playing up against a goaltender that is 6'7", he covers a lot of net. Less is more is another phrase you use automatically, but he can intimidate a shooter because he is so big. And if he's on his knees, you think you got something up high, there's not much there. He's a good puck handler. So the minute that you dump a puck in that's in the wrong spot and you go for a line change, especially in the second period, look out, because he plays the puck as well as anybody plays the puck. So there's a lot of areas to look at when you scout or when you just look at the way Ben Bishop is.
The other guy that you get to see a lot, what a debut it's been. What a debut it's been for Jordan Binnington. You know what? You guys are in St. Louis are calling him Winnington, and you should, because he's helped you get off the mat, out of the cellar, and not only get into the Stanley Cup playoffs, but take down the lethal Winnipeg Jets, the stacked Winnipeg Jets. And Jordan Binnington, I'm just blown away by his mentality, his conviction, and his belief, and not only his skills, but in terms of, as he told me, what his responsibility is for his teammates. That was very impressive. He said that whenever he got to the NHL, he promised himself he was going to make an impact. Boy, oh boy, has he exceeded that. He's beyond made an impact.
Yeah.
It's been great to watch.
28 wins in your first 36 starts.
Is that pretty good?
I think that works out to good. Be pretty well. During the regular season, he never lost 2 games in a row.
Incredible, man.
That's a sign of resolve and just parking things, you know, that are there. He's got this control alt delete button that just goes, okay, let's get rid of it. Let's move on to the next one. And the stats against Winnipeg, you'd be hard pressed to find the greatest goalie that's ever played have great stats against Winnipeg Jets, because their cross seam passes, the quality of the chances they get in the slot areas and dot to dot. The bottom line is winning a game against the Winnipeg Jets. And he found a way to win hockey games and never really let the game get away from him, other than game 3 in St. Louis was the only time I saw actually a bad goal. Bufflin hit him off the shoulder, and it didn't happen again. So he doesn't give up those momentum-sapping goals against.
And he makes timely big saves, and the saves he should make, but also some to where you're slack-jawed after you see. And a lot of those, too, he's making in 2 and 3 save successions as well. So I'm really pumped to see how well he's played, and I'm just going to go back to your point with Ben Bishop, because I love your point about him being a homegrown St. Louis kid. And when we see this wave of young St. Louis players like the Tkachuks, like Clayton Keller, we can go up and down. Ben Bishop was at the forefront of that, and Cam Jansen, so nice to see. Yeah.
Mr. Winnington, though, is going to have to figure out a way to contain Jamie Benn.
Oh.
How about those numbers?
Hey.
Regular season and playoffs, we tallied it all together here. 46 games, 44 points. And you know he's going to turn it up a notch for this series.
Lindros Light, that's what I call him, left-handed Lindros Light. I've spoken to the great Eric Lindros about it. I asked him, who's the one guy that reminds you somewhat of yourself in the league now? He said, if I had to pick a guy, it would be Jamie Benn. That is the ultimate compliment, Panger. Over to you.
Well, he plays so well against St. Louis. It's like a personal vendetta that he has against the team. He fought David Backes a number of years ago. This is while Backes is a member of the Boston Bruins. He did so again while Backes was the captain of the St. Louis Blues. He goes in there and he says, where's the head of the snake and what can I cut off? And then he goes and attacks it time and time again. And there's been many games I've seen Jamie Benn play against the Blues where maybe he doesn't even have a point. He might even be a minus one. But he made the one hit that changed the momentum of the game, or he did something that changed it and elevated it. And that's an area, to me, he is the head of the snake of the Dallas Stars in the way that he plays against the St. Louis Blues. And they're more than just a one-trick pony. They're more than this top line. This second line, Rupi Hintz, and you've got Dickinson on the left. You got Zuccarello on the third line. You got Blake Como playing well. They're a good hockey club, and they're playing with a lot of confidence and a lot of speed right now.
Yep, Jim Montgomery's done an outstanding job with them. He knew they were a go-go-go team, but this year, after getting the controls, Hitch made some nice inroads in terms of their defensive game and some improvements, and he said, hey, you know what, we got to D these guys up. They're second in the league in regular season in goals against, so that's a testament to him and their team and their commitment level. Rick Bowness as well.
That's going to be a good series.